What is going on, my soldier game is? Are you commander in chief, Warzone 157, and welcome to another episode of Warzone Talks. Now, if you're new to my channel, welcome. Hope you all enjoy your stay. And here is the rundown of this series that I do. I go ahead and I find some of the most awesome and well-deserved and very creative YouTube content creators out there who are small and at the same time having a tough time, getting their names heard in this community of today. And that's where I come in. Now, even though I am a small content creator as well, I do what I can to try and give positive feedback and do whatever I can to help out, which means, you know, I also give positive feedback, subscribing to them, and also this shout out. So now, if you're wondering, this is going to be a throwback shout out episode, which means whatever shout outs that I gave them to some people in the beginning of Warzone Talks or throughout my whole entire series, I go back and I keep them in the loop and commemorate them for everything that they're doing. And what you're looking at for gameplay is Warface. Besides Counter-Strike, which you saw in the last few Warzone Talks, I actually played this game first, and I like it because if you don't really want to play competitively, you can also play cooperatively. And I think that's pretty cool. And also, there's a survival mode on this too. And every single time that you go back in the game each day, they give you gifts and items for you to use, which is freaking awesome. Now, you're just looking at some good old video footage of a console peasant like myself getting wrecked, but at the same time, when you piss me off, war mode gets engaged and I hit you back tenfold. But before anything else, let's get on with the shoutouts, why don't we? First off, we have Jamiya Star. She has 9 subs and she also does a lot of prank videos and a milk challenge video, which is innocent at some point, but then something happens. I'm gonna let you guys figure that out. And she's just starting out, so go easy on her. And Jamiya, keep going with these awesome videos and hope to see you get more subscribers in the near future. Next up, we have Batboy YT. And he is making his way. He's got 211 subs, and he's also a gamer and commentator. And he plays a lot of Minecraft and Terraria, primarily Terraria. And he... What was I going to say? Oh, God, my mind just went blank. Oh, almost forgot, right? He also does videos on displaying what the updates are for, you know, the updates you give when playing Terraria. And not only that, he does a small playlist of a selection of songs for you to use either in the background for music, that being either for an intro, an outro, music throughout your gameplay or whatever you're trying to say, or when you're just doing a vlog, which I think is pretty freaking awesome. So you don't really have to go do that with the trouble of, you know, going on YouTube and going on all these other music websites just to find that one song to use. Next up, we have CobraSG34. He is pretty much the counterpart and battlefield buddy of Batboy YT. And he's also a gamer and commentator. Created his own intro. Not sure if he created his own outro too, but if he did, that's freaking awesome. And he also did a collaboration with Batboy. His, I forget the word, dynamic duo. Those guys are like, I don't know what's a good old synonym to use or a good saying, but pretty much they're like a big bond. They're like brothers. Not also does he do a collaboration, he also does shout outs. He also gave me one, which I think is pretty freaking cool. I don't know if it was Cobra or if it was Batboy. Also gave me a website of some guy who is a YouTuber, but also goes to the, you know, the top 5 or top 15 best YouTubers. And if you want, you can just put your name, your channel, and what you do. And just pretty much hope that the ballot goes on your name. And next thing you know, bam, he's making a YouTube channel. And or making a YouTube video of your channel and others. But just to let you know, you submit once, you submit twice, you're disqualified. I don't know how long, I don't know if it's forever, for a lifetime, I don't know. And these guys are really awesome, so you guys, I'm really surprised that Cobra hasn't gotten those many subs. I mean, I don't know if he made a jump, I hope we did. I'm gonna go back and see what happened, what's going on. But yeah, definitely check out these channels because these guys are very creative and very awesome because they play on iOS. And I'm not sure if that's a tablet for the iPhone, for the Apple industry, or if it's an iPhone. But they make it seem really, really easy to play these first-person shooters, which I think is cool. And they're also doing face cams and such. And these guys are so young, it's awesome. Next up, we have The Ominous Shark. People are making so many groundbreaking achievements and goals because not only are they making, not only Bat Boy and Cobra going up there in subscribers, guess what? Ominous Shark just broke his 100th subscriber of today. So congratulations, Ominous Shark, man. You're making some awesome things. And you want to know what he does? He does gaming news and other reviews for Halo, pretty much the whole entire series, Destiny, and Battlefield Hardline. Doesn't do that too many for Battlefield Hardline. He's mostly just Halo and Destiny, which I can go get behind because I am a huge Halo fan. Destiny, anyway, he also made an amazing and awesome Halo 3 Machinima, and it is freaking awesome. He did all the sound, the narrations himself, and I'm not sure if he did the other, you know, camera angles and skits himself, or if he had other people do it with him, but it's really cool. Everything from the channels to the videos, they're going to be in the description below. So if you want to check out their videos and see what you're getting yourself into, then by all means, go ahead and see what they have in store. Also their channel, so if you want to hit that like button or hit that channel button first, then view their content, I give you guys a lot of options. And not only that, he's also, to show his appreciation for your dedication, he's also doing a lobby for friends and fans and for other people on Xbox One if you have the Master Chief Collection. Pretty much play a whole bunch of matchmaking games and also playing something of some kind of map that he's been in development and making for like 6 months now. He's still working out the bugs. I'm not sure if it's a map or if it's something else that he's doing. Definitely look up the video that is going to be underneath his channel. Link. There we go. And next up we have his another counterpart, another back-to-back double duo, or dynamic duo, Spartan I-99. He has 209 subs. He's broken the barrier to 200, which is also freaking amazing. And he's also a gamer and commentator and also a reviewer and Let's Player. Now, what he's doing for Let's Plays, he's playing Tomb Raider, the prologue to Rise of the Tomb Raider. And I'm getting into that, and I like it. It's very, very cool. I'm thinking about doing it for my channel as well. And he also does amazing videos and talking about Halo news as well. So all you guys from Jemiah and Spartan I-99, you guys rock, keep doing what you're doing, and just, keep breaking barriers. That's not going to be the topic of this rant that I'm going to be doing, but it's just going to be things from what I thought of E3, but besides that, we have the last few people, and when it's the last few people, or whenever I say the last person, or last few, they are the celebrities of the week, and I actually have two instead of one this time. First off, Offshot Gaming. And he has 74 subscribers, and he's also, gamer and commentator. And he doesn't really commentate that much. He has his own little his own series called Testing Out. Pretty much what he does, he plays games on his PC, and to him, if he likes it and his viewers like it, he's gonna make a whole entire series at it. If not, then he's just going to, just let that one video be that one video and then go on to the next one, which is very, very impressive. It keeps you from not making too many videos that you don't want to do for a certain series, and give yourself many, many options and giving your viewers more options as well. And yeah, that's pretty much it. And he also does a lot of Let's Plays too. And one, the type of video that Sorry, god dang tongue twisters, or maybe I'm just going retarded every single video that I make. He also plays a lot of games such as Saints Row 4, also plays Tomb Raider, which I am enjoying as well, and Dynasty Warriors, which I've never played, but it looks very intriguing to like the amount of people that you can just smash at one time with a very freaking amazing and overpowering finishing moves or big special moves. I've been on a console that had that game. I think they were all for like PS2, PS3 and stuff like that. But man, oh man, it's awesome. And I guess since we tied, even though they won, they have their heads in shame, which I thought was pretty freaking hilarious. And we have, I forgot my other one. And this guy has also not only all shot showing dedication also in the comments of all videos that I make. Here comes another one. And can I get a drum roll, please? I don't know if I'm making your eardrums discombobulated, but we have Lukey Doo. And he has 58 subscribers. And last time I checked, he was around, I guess, 40, maybe 30. So he's making a big jump as well. And I have to say, he has been an awesome gamer and commentator, playing a lot of Let's Plays of Luigi Mansion and also playing some little horror mini flash games. I think it was Lullaby for a Toaster. That to me wasn't scary, but it was very, very suspenseful, and it was very well put together. I think the game was made in like, I don't know if it was made in 24 hours or not, but it was something for like a Game Jam, I think that's what it was called, but it looked really good. And not only that, he has Lukey Doo Talks, and it is amazing. Shout out, I don't know if that's his actual episode or has a name of his series, and I do feel embarrassed that I'm forgetting most of this stuff because I just looked at all of these videos that these people are doing and I can't remember, so it is very embarrassing. I feel like my mentality of my old soul, which feels like it's 54, I'm guessing it's kicking in to where I can't remember too many things at once, and it's very disturbing. And he also did a funny little hot sauce challenge, which he curses a lot, so he tries to, you know, not try to curse so much, or if anything at all, while he was eating all this hot sauce and he was playing a very rage and stressful induced puzzle game. And he actually, oh well, that's it. But that's all for the shout outs. If you all want a shout out as well, be sure to let me know in the comment section below of any video that I do. If not this one, the other Batman Arkham Knight video that is going to be uploaded. I know I did say that I was going to do a third one before Warzone Talks, but I've been very, very busy. Just work has been nipping me in the whole entire butt. It's like not just one cheek, not just the other cheek, but all the cheeks, even to the taint. I don't like it. Ranting time. I have to say, this year's E3, it was awesome. I'm not gonna lie. The video games that I saw in every single press conference, that being from Xbox or Microsoft to Sony and PS4 to freaking Ubisoft, Bethesda, even though they didn't have those many audience, and to them it kind of sounded a little bland, Square Enix, dude, Kingdom Hearts 3 finally coming out. I mean, what? Like, I also saw gameplay from Halo 5 Guardians. They're bringing back a lot of cool, awesome things, making Halo feel like Halo. They didn't get it all in Call of Duty and making you not feel that vibe that it is Halo. You're going to be able to play different sides, from Spartan Locke to Master Chief, and then I don't really know how the gameplay for Master Chief is going to be, because it only showed the part for Spartan Locke, but we have a new Forerunner antagonist that I'm guessing for some reason was, Didac's brother, or was a believer of Didac's mission and what he was trying to do. I'm not sure if Dr. Halsey's gonna come back into play. But dude, it seems so awesome because I don't know if this is what they're trying to do. But when I saw the trailer for what was going to be in the next game, for some reason it looked very Egyptian to me. From the serpents, and I'm guessing this is a new type of flood or something, but it looked Egyptian from like pillars and from the little serpent things and the way that the new Forerunner antagonist looked, he looks like a freaking pharaoh. And that some parts of the soundtrack, it sounded like Egyptian music. I don't know if this is just speculation. But then I saw Warzone. They gave me my name and put it inside that. PvEvP. Player versus player and player versus enemies, which means AI antagonist. Now, what I saw from the gameplay, it looked really cool. But what I also noticed is the enemies seem to go down a little bit harder, so I am hoping that they can buff the health and shields up with the enemies and making them just as hard as the other characters or as the other players. And also saw a new vehicle, don't remember what it's called, but it looked freaking fantastic. Now I'm gonna get off the subject of that. Look at this. Knight and Cavalry. Cavalry was the one guy in this game who pissed me off because he sat in that area for all match. And I was really freaking tired. I'm like, when am I gonna kill him? I went over there just for him. Because he pissed me off that much. But I get my revenge on both of them. Now with the indie games, extremely excited for Cuphead. Like, I grew up watching so many, I don't know if it was things like 1930s all the way up to the 90s, but whatever in that time frame, from Popeye to Tom and Jerry to Top Cat and all the other ones, Wacky Races. I grew up watching all of them. It looked like a actual cartoon show, and it's just amazing. I just can't believe that it's actually coming, and I can't wait to see what some YouTubers are going to be doing to that game. And I mean, series-wise. Also for Sony, The Last Guardian's finally coming out. We saw some awesome stuff from a thing called Horizon, which looks like Jurassic Park gone metal. And I also saw Uncharted 4, and I'm actually, at the end of this year, I'm going to be buying a PS4 and getting the addition of playing all of the Uncharted games. And let me see, what else? I don't think there was too much for, No Man's Land looks freaking sick. It's so freaking big. All the little dots you saw on the gameplay or planets, so you can be going to each and every planet. I don't even think you can pretty much be done with that game in one lifespan. You'd have to be bicentennial, man. Nintendo, can't really say I enjoyed it. All there was Muppets, 3DS Muppets, Mario Muppets, 3DS Muppets. It was so weird. I felt very uncomfortable, but I mean, I'm not gonna lie, the games do look awesome. I'm glad they're bringing Star Fox back. Metroid Prime, even though it's not gonna be for the Wii U, it's gonna be for the 3DS, which I think should also be on the Wii U. But I think they're gonna be killing that console, and I don't know why, because it's really fun. Square Enix, Kingdom Hearts 3, and Just Cause. Super excited. And, let us not forget, my man, Deus Ex. I think it's called Human Revolution. Or it might be something else. I can't remember. I do apologize. Like I said, mental thought not working so well. And from what I saw from Ubisoft, more stuff from Rainbow Six Siege, a new game for Honor, which looked beastly. My God, cannot wait for that game to drop down on the platforms. Assassin's Creed Syndicate. Since it doesn't have a proper story outside of the Animus, I can't really be excited for. And for the best game that I have seen thus far, Ghost Recon Wildlands. That is going to be the most sick multiplayer, wide, worldwide, cooperative gameplay game ever. And I'm super excited. I can't wait for the new Splinter Cell. Haven't heard too much from that, but I hope it's coming in. Next up, we have Gears of War 4. Looks very cool. Looks very linear, which I don't really see the people who made this game to be linear. I hope not. It's just, I'm guessing it's just a teaser of how it's going to look and how it's going to be. And if there was anything else, Bethesda, Fallout 4, making your own stuff, getting new companions, and also dialogue now for your character, which is sick as well. And Doom! Oh my god, the id Software, the executions, the guns, the graphics and visuals, the executions, the weapons, the executions! Oh my god, I am having a gaming nerdgasm so much right now. Division and Ghost Recon Wild Hunt, I'm more excited for with Ubisoft. Anything else? Not that much. Oh wait, For Honor as well. I'm just going back and saying what I thought about all of these things. And oh my god, this has been a good year for everyone. So, yeah man, that's gonna be about it. Let me know in the comment section what you guys thought about all the press conferences for each group and developer. And tell me what you think they should have done better or what you thought really sold you. Oh, and by the way, Xbox One backwards compatibility. Really hope that they do it for the PS4 as well. And yeah, that's gonna be about it. Definitely check out these YouTubers. Definitely subscribe to them and view their content. You will not be sorry for everything that they are doing. And if you like to see me, my personal firing squad, murder that like button. If you have a YouTube channel as well, let me know in the comment section below. And if this was the best video you've seen thus far, please add to your favorites and let people know what I do for this channel. And if you want to become a part of my army today, because I want you to have your name heard and be entertained, then by all means, subscribe to stay updated by signing in. As always, this is Warzone 157, reminding you to keep your eyes on the prize and finger on the trigger at all times. This is going to be the end of my transmission, and I will see you soldiers in the next battle log. So have a good day, night, wherever you're from, and as always, my soldiers, Warzone out. See you in Arkham Knight.